In this illustration, we'll study about the temperature variation of a conductor. Here we are given that a conductor has a temperature independent resistance R and heat capacity C. And it is given that at T equal to 0, it is connected to a voltage V. And we are required to find the temperature of conductor as a function of time. It is also given that thermal power dissipated to surrounding depends on temperature of conductor as K times T minus T naught joule per second, where K is a constant and T naught is the surrounding temperature. Here this is the rate at which heat is being dissipated to surrounding, and we know thermal power generated in a resistance can be given as V square by R. So here we can write one conductor is at temperature T. The rate of heat absorption by conductor is, this can be written as dq by dt, which is the rate of accumulation of heat within the conductor, which can be written as V square by R minus K times T minus T naught. As this is the total amount of heat per unit time generated within the resistance due to current flowing through it, and thus the amount dissipated to surroundings. So the difference would be the one which is absorbed by conductor. It will further raise the temperature of conductor. And here we can write dq as C dt if dt is the rise in temperature due to dq absorption of heat, as C is given as heat capacity. Here we can write it as C dt by dt is equals to this V square minus kr T minus T naught divided by R. And further we can write it as C dt divided by V square minus kr T minus T naught. This equals to, we can write it as dt by R. And here if we integrate this function, at T equals to 0, the temperature of conductor would be equals to surrounding temperature, and at a general time T, after switching on the battery, it is reached to a temperature T. So on integrating, this will be given as the C, and on integrating this will get minus 1 by kr ln of V square minus kr times T minus T naught, and we apply its limit from T naught to T, and this is T by R. Here R gets cancelled out, and further if we continue here, this will be ln of V square minus kr T minus T naught divided by, when you put the lower limit T naught, this term will be 0, so this V square only. This equals to minus kT by C. Here if we further solve, this will give us V square minus kr T minus T naught is equals to V square e to power minus kT by C. Or simplifying, we get the value of T as T naught plus V square by kr 1 minus e to power minus kT by C. That will be the result of this problem, the temperature of this conductor as a function of time.